we hear such incredible news about a discovery that a child, you know, it's early days, but a child has, it looks as if she's been cured of HIV, that at the same time, sort of government by daring is going to cause a large reduction in our nation's investment in medical research. To me, that's just, it's crazy, if you will. Research means hope. Research can bring change to the human condition, and research actually can bring human dignity to patients. And governmental leaders need to understand that the investments that they've been making in the biomedical research enterprise are actually fueling these great discoveries. And much like an engine on takeoff, this is no time to take the fuel out of the tank. We really need government leaders to get back to the table, to talk with each other, and to get back to a position where we can invest in the National Institutes of Health, the National Science Foundation, NASA, and the other great science enterprises that exist here in our country. Our biomedical research enterprise is the envy of the world. In fact, there were papers last year in the New England Journal talking about the investments being made in Singapore and in China and in other developing countries. And the fact that we would have our talent potentially poached because our government chooses through the blunt axe instrument of sequestration to actually reduce funding for research is really not a thoughtful way to deal with the budget challenges facing the nation.